Point O is the center of both circles in the figure above. If the circumference of the larger circle is 36, so the circumference of the larger circle there is 36, and the radius of the small circle is half the radius of the larger circle, what is the length of the darkened arc? So if you have half the radius, you're going to have half the circumference. And we could even solve for what that radius is. So you want to know what the radius of the larger circle is? Well, the larger circle, we could say 2 pi times its radius is equal to 36. And so its radius, if you divide both sides by 2 pi, its radius is going to be equal to 36 divided by 2 is 18 over pi. That's the larger circle. Now, the smaller circle has a radius half of the radius of the larger circle. So the smaller circle's radius is, so radius, and I'll write a little sub s there, for the radius of the smaller circle is going to be half this, or it's going to be 9 over pi. And so the circumference of the smaller circle, the circumference of the smaller circle is going to be its radius, 9 over pi, times 2 pi. And so pi divided by pi, and so you're going to have 9 times 2 is equal to 18. And so the circumference here is 18. And it might have already jumped out at you because circumference is directly proportional to, because circumference for any circle is directly proportional to radius, if you have half the radius, you're going to have half the circumference. And you wouldn't have had to go through all of this. You could have said, hey, okay, if I have a radius here of 36, and if I have a circumference here of 36, and if I have a circle with half the radius, its circumference is going to be half that. It's going to be 18. But that's not what they're asking us. They're not asking us just the circumference of the smaller circle. They're asking us, what is the arc length? What is the arc length of this part right over here, this 80 degrees? Well, 80 degrees, remember, to go all the way around the circle is 360 degrees. So this is 80/360ths of the entire circle right over here, of the entire circumference. So if you want that arc length, it's going to be the circumference times 80/360ths times 80/360. And that's the same thing as, let's see, divide both of them by 10, that's the same thing as 8/36ths. And let's see, you could divide 8 divided by 4 is 2, and then 36 divided by 4 is 9. And then you are left with, let's see, 18 divided by 9 is 2. So you're left with 2 times 2 is equal to 4. And you're done.